What's up, you guys? Hey, Byron Rogers here, protector by nature and by trade. Want to talk to you about Ed Calderon's Organic Medium class. This last week, I went through this course with Ed where basically I got a very intimate relationship with my weapon, my daily carry weapon, my daily carry blade. It was pretty much unlike anything I'd ever seen before or done. It was definitely unlike anything I'd ever done before. I think what's most important about this course is simply that a lot of people have preconceived notions about blade work and about fighting with a knife. And there's so much romanticism around fighting with a blade that it's easy to have these just misconceptions. You know, I, for a long time, I've always been a karambit guy, mostly because through my studies, I really discovered that I think it looks cool. You know what I mean? Like, that's really what it was. It's like, yo, these look cool. I do look at the blade and think like, wow, I can do a lot of damage with this blade in these ways, really, you know what I'm saying? Which is good to know and good to understand. Like, you can look at a tool and you can understand organically, like, okay, I can do a lot with this just because I know what I'm capable of and I know with this in my hand I can do things. But when you really start to study, not the art of knife fighting, but what's taking place in knife fights right now today, you start to find that maybe a curved blade does have some disadvantages that I don't want to deal with. You got to go to the class to find out what they are. Maybe it's not the smartest killing mechanism, you know what I'm saying? Or fighting tool to use. And I say these things because we all know violence, when violence is happening, the whole entire situation is who can inflict the most catastrophic damage on the other opponent the quickest in order to immobilize, in order to stop the threat. So whether that has to do with immobilization or elimination, those things are, we can murder board that later. But in order to stop the threat from taking place, you know, if you're coming at it from a protector's standpoint. Quick disclaimer, karambits are still awesome. They're amazing. Don't get crazy, karambit guys. I'm just saying, because I don't have time to train long enough to become good with one of those, I think there's a lot of reasons why most of the time you find weapons that have been manufactured to kill people, you know, when you find blades or like pointed objects that have been manufactured to kill people, they have that straight nature to them. And I believe, and based on a lot of the stuff that I'm finding, it has to do with how simple, the simplicity of it. There's a number of reasons. I love karambits. I want to become a karambit ninja, but at my current level of skill, it's best for me to carry a straight blade. That's what I believe. So anyways, just on the karambit thing, disclaimer, I still love karambit, so I still probably carry one from time to time. But straight blades is, I think, really where the journey begins, right? In my opinion.
So I learned a lot about the different blades, and I learned a lot about their advantages, disadvantages, you know, their strengths and their weaknesses. And I got to feel what they were capable of. And that's something I had also never had happen. There were some blades, you know, we didn't even get to really run because the instructors could just look at it and be like, that's a liability. Here's why. And that is an invaluable experience. And, you know, as a result, I've even changed the blade I usually rock. And I'm looking into some different types of blades that I'm going to carry, you know. The evolution of knife fighting is happening in places where people are getting stabbed frequently. One of the biggest hotbeds, and this is all content that, you know, I got from the course. One of the biggest hotbeds is prisons. You know, how do you take a kid who's been in some fights, a pretty tough kid, but turn him into an extremely lethal killer with any kind of sharp or pointy object, you know, in a week or two, you know? So the software is out there. Making people efficient with blades is happening all the time all around us. Figuring out how to make blades out of anything. The other component to this course was not just understanding strike patterns, attack patterns to make you proficient and efficient with a sharp object, a penetrating object very quickly. But the other piece of it that was really cool was understanding how to source everything you need in order to be armed. After this course, you will never not be armed again. After this course, you will legitimately look at the world. You'll be seeing through the matrix, through the fabric, into the bad curtain of the world, and you'll be like, cool, I can make a weapon out of this, and this. Defend myself. You know what I mean? So it's a great course for anyone to take. Dad, mom, daughter, you know, son. If you know, obviously there's some age limitations because a lot of the content is extremely real world and shows how effective the techniques and tactics that you're aiming to implement really truly are, you know. And there's something very visceral and very sensual, meaning in touch with all five senses. There's something very visceral and sensual about blade work because it's just gruesome, you know. I almost fear a guy with a knife more than a guy with a gun. It's a whole different piece of content, different psychology, man. But nonetheless, the course was amazing. Having the experience with my blades was amazing. Upgrading my thinking was amazing because the software, like one mind, many weapons, one mind, any weapon, as the Marine Corps says, the software is what runs us. I should be able to pick up any pistol and get down, any rifle and get down, any blade and get down. That's the idea here. That's why protection's more than just a job. It's a lifestyle. You need to live a lifestyle that's going to be able to make you the most proficient and effective protector. That's what the Protector Nation's about, brand is about. That's what Executive Protection Lifestyle brand's about. Hard skills intensives that we're doing, the symposiums that we're doing. It's all about bringing you skills and life skills that are going to help you live the life of a protector, right? So
we can't be good about protecting ourselves or detecting something if we don't recognize or know how to do it ourselves, basically. Doing a class for executive protection guys and going into the subject matter of ambushing and counter-ambushing.
Ed Calderon's Organic Medium course was amazing. The experiences I got with my blade was amazing. Upgrading my thinking was amazing. Training with these guys was the whole class. We went in and got into these breakout sessions. And the way that we trained allowed us to train at a higher level of speed and intensity in a safe way than, you know, I've ever seen done in another course. So we got to really go at it with each other and really learn, like, you know, there's not much fighting in these blade encounters. It's more like, you know, killers don't want, if it's a killer, you won't see the blade. If you do, you're lucky. And then you get stabbed a lot. You know what I'm saying? So what are the ways to deal with that? What are the ways to execute on that? This whole dueling kind of thing that people think about, you know, like it's like we're in Greece or, you know, a Michael Jackson music video, is not what is taking place in reality. So on the streets and in prisons and places where people are getting stabbed. So I heavily, heavily recommend, I don't care if you're on an EP team, police, just responsible citizen, go check out this Organic Medium course and put some real world experience behind the pocket knife you choose to carry every single day. I will say shout out to Emerson. My Emerson held up great, functioned great, and it's an honor to carry it. And it's what I have on me right now. But going up that IQ, because you can take guns some places, but you can take knives or source blades or make something pretty much any place. Anyways, big shout out to Ed Calderon and what he's doing, making the world a safer place by helping good people become more dangerous. And I just want to say, this course was probably the course that made me more deadly, more dangerous than any other course I'd taken this year. And I want to say thanks for having me, and I look forward to all the things we're doing together, Ed, especially this upcoming Hard Skills Intensive. Catch Ed at this upcoming Hard Skills Intensive, and I'll see y'all on the next video. This is Byron Rogers, protector by nature and by trade, reminding you to be peaceful but not harmless. Out.
What was the best performing thing out of everything used?
Victorinox.
But the other, what was the other one?
Kitchen knife.
Walmart.
Yeah.
Murder fucking tool.
Home and special shout out to Jason Johnson. He's the knife throwing extraordinaire that I'm working with in the video. So like, he came to the course, and me and him have a podcast episode. You guys got to go check it out. It's number 17. Phenomenal guy, phenomenal patriot.
And it's an honor. Me and him actually got some pretty cool stuff coming up. But if you don't know who he is, Jason Johnson, he throws a knife like Randy Johnson throws a baseball. You got that Randy Johnson vibe. But anyways, really cool dude. And it's always an honor when our paths cross. We got some cool stuff coming for Protect Your Nation. But he was at the course. We were working one-on-one quite a bit as well. So I actually got to learn from Ed and Jason like at the same time. It was crazy. Anyways, you go to good courses, you meet good people. A lot of course, going to good courses is actually about networking, even if you're not in the private security industry. Just meeting good people who want to get after it the same way you do. So special thanks to Jason. Thanks for coming and training me, bro. Can't wait to do some more cool stuff with you. And if you guys don't know who he is, go check out our podcast episode on the Protector podcast number 17. And go watch this dude throw some knives and blow your mind. Oh, and he's got a line of knives you guys got to check out as well. Boom. Yo, another special thanks to Tidwell Knife and Tool. Yo, I got to use the Buster in ways I never thought I would at this course. And it, like, I mean, it worked so well, it almost scared me. Like, I was like, oh, like, you ever pick up a knife and, like, how do I say this? It just has a presence to it. That's what this Buster's like. Stand by, I'm gonna do a tactical review and just get up into it. But Tidwell Knife and Tool, amazing work. Every single person that's seen has been blown away. So that's the big black knife you guys see me wielding in there, the alien killing looking knife. Anyways, y'all, yeah, it's good stuff. But look up Tidwell Knife and Tool if you guys haven't. They are awesome. My man's work is awesome. And yeah, just thankful and grateful to be connected with awesome people.